So you can probably tell I have a crush on Alberta, right? I think I want to say something to her.
Wow. Pete has a crush on Alberta and he wants to tell her.
Okay, so we're looping Jay in on this one.
Wait, hasn't he known her for decades? Why is he making the move now?
Well, I'm a loyal guy and my wife was still very much alive, but then you asked her to come visit the house and I found out she was a dirty, lying cheater. So what do you think?
I love that you came to me, but I have one foot out the door right now.
Just tell me what to do. Should I say something?
Pete, you're a sweet guy, but I've only heard her talk about dating bootleggers or mob bosses.
Oh, you don't think I'm a bad boy? You know, I ripped the tag off a mattress one time. That's a federal offense, baby.
Wow, I can't believe Pete is gonna tell Alberta he's got a crush on her.
What now?
I'm rooting for Arrow Guy.
Please don't say anything. I think I talked him out of it anyway.
What if I really want to say something, though?
Please don't.
Let's go, babe.
Before Jay and Sam, we used to entertain ourselves, remember? Food club, movie club, we'd talk for hours. Who wants to hear me describe meatballs? Now, fun fact, that's actually a food and a movie.
This is hell. I'm in hell.
The movie stars Bill Murray as a fun-loving, wisecracking counselor at a summer camp. And the food, well, you guys know what the food is. It's pretty self-explanatory, but we got the time, so I'll explain it.
Pete's planning on telling Alberta that he likes her.
What?
What? I'm sorry, Pete, but I overheard Jay, and I didn't want to say anything, and then the TV shut off, and then you forced my hand with this whole meatballs lecture.
Maybe we should go talk about this in the other room, Pete.
Although, if it's good news for Pete, perhaps we should all be a part of it to celebrate together.
Yeah, maybe the other room.
Boy.
Well, I did tell her that I had feelings for someone, but that someone was my girlfriend.
Oh. Girlfriend? What, you got a girlfriend?
One of you mating with Pete?
I don't think so.
Well, actually, I don't think you guys know her.
How would we not know her?
Because she lives downstairs.
In the cholera pit?
Oh. Yeah, the cholera pit.
Well, I for one would love to meet her.
Well, I'll go talk to her about it right now. Downstairs, where she definitely lives. Here I go. Be back with my girlfriend. I'm in kind of a bind and need a volunteer to be my fake girlfriend.
I'll do it.
Really? You will?
Nancy, we don't go up there. We stay with our kind.
I am not your kind. I want a better afterlife than this. All you guys do is stand around talking about the water heater. It's boring.
Okay, well, Nancy has thrown her hat in the ring, which is great, but I want to, you know, be fair to all of the ladies of the pit. So how about the quiet one in the back there with a smile?
Oh, yeah, she doesn't have a tongue. And let me tell you, that is her no face. Now listen up, I will help you out. But just to be clear, there is nothing happening here sexually.
Okay, noted.
All right, let's do this then, huh?
Okay. Oh, I didn't know ghosts could sweat.
Oh no, it's pus from an infected wound.
Ah, that explains it. So, there were a lot of rumors going around today about how I didn't have a girlfriend, and about how maybe I just made that up in a blind, sweaty panic, but here she is, in the flesh.
The rotting flesh?
Nancy, from the cholera pit.
Well, originally from Albany, but then I got sick and they threw me in the pest house, which they told us was some sort of recovery ward, but then they nailed the door shut. That was not a good sign.
How did you two meet?
Well, that's a fun story.
Yeah, he came downstairs trolling for sex.
Okay, she's a joker, loves to tell jokes. It's actually one of the things I like about her.
What are some of the other things?
Well, our shared love of...
The water heater.
Right.
Pete, you love the water heater?
Yeah.
He loves the water heater.
Well,
he could go on for hours talking calibration and combustion and corrosion and de-liming.
De-liming. I love de-liming.
Sometimes when we're doing it, I'll get on his back like a horse and I'll steer him around by his arrow.
That is very vivid imagery. Thank you, Nancy.
Oh, I got a lot more images for you. Here we go. this one time?
Nancy is amazing. Such a free spirit. No pun intended.
And I was like, you're so wild, but
and she seems really happy. You must be a good boyfriend, Pete.
So, we should probably get going back down. Glad you guys got to meet my real girlfriend. Now it's time to head downstairs.
Whoa. Pete, come on. She just got here.
Yeah, we don't even know how long you date or how far she throw axe.
Actually, yeah, I thought I might just maybe stay up here.
What's that?
I mean, we might as well stop sneaking around, right, baby?
Well, we're not sneaking around.
I spend every night in Pete's room. There, it's out there in the open. I feel relieved.
Yeah,
everyone can know.
I feel great, too. Yeah. What are you doing?
I'm not ready to go back yet. I think I might stay for a while.
Ah, look, they're whispering sweet nothings.
You better get used to me. This guy, right? Isn't he just the best? Ooh, isn't he just the best? He's the best. Oh, yeah, do that again.
Okay.
Who's this?
Hi, Nancy. I'm Pete's girlfriend.
Pete's girlfriend?
Huh?
There's a new ghost.
Sure. Cool.
Yep. Yeah. Nancy's my girlfriend that sleeps upstairs in my room with me. We're practically inseparable. There's no getting away from her.
Mm-hmm.
Honey? Should I?
Looks like I'm gonna get some. I can't believe you sleep in a bed every night. Ooh, a girl could really get used to this pillow business.
Yep. I could have used one. Oh, God. Hey, would you mind rubbing this knot in my shoulder, Nancy?
Hey, you know the rules. This is a fake relationship, so I am not rubbing any of your man parts.
I mean, technically everyone has shoulders.
Ooh, now how about we head downstairs and get that living butler to make us something to smell for breakfast?
You mean Sam? She's actually a writer and a small business owner. She's not our butler.
Oh, okay. Too good to be a butler. You know, when I was alive, women couldn't even be a butler. You could be a wench, a midwife, or a whore.
Oh, well, that's not something I feel particularly compelled to follow up on.
So you just gave away our pillow palace to some rando sister?
It's not some rando, it's Jay.
Who the hell's Jay?
Sam's husband?
Huh?
The living butler's husband?
Oh, face it, Pete. You're a pushover.
Because I gave in on one little thing in the interest of house harmony?
You didn't give in on one thing. You give in on everything. You told me yourself you never get to pick the movie on movie night.
Well, that's true.
And you're always the caboose in the massage train.
I mean, someone's gotta be.
Why can't it be a circle, huh? That way everyone gets their man parts rubbed.
Again, shoulders are not specific to men.
You start standing up for yourself and get our room back, or I will tell everyone our relationship is fake and that you have a huge crush on Alberta.
You know, there's a certain irony to you strong-arming me into being less of a pushover.
That did not escape me, Pete.
This'll just take a minute.
Well, what is this? Isaac and I were in the middle of a riveting debate on scarves.
You got this, Pete, just like we practiced.
Listen up, ghosts. I have spent the last 40 years bending over backwards to compromise for the sake of house harmony. But I'm here to tell you, I'm done. I've had it up to my arrow with all of your applesauce. It's time for Pete to finally get what he wants.
And he wants a mold-free room, so one of you is making way for Pete and his girl.
If that's amenable to everyone. Or even if it's not.
Yeah.
Also, I will no longer be the caboose on the massage train. I lead it now. I'm the engine.
You hear that? Let's go.
All right.
Well, the moment we all feared has arrived. Pete's developed the spine.
This is an unfortunate turn of events.
That's Hetty, Alberta, oh, and me. Three against one. Thor, you must give up your room to Pete and the filthy one.
Mm-mm. Thor not moving.
But we voted.
Thor not believe in democracy.
Oh, how convenient.
Fine. I changed my vote to Isaac. Me too.
Weasels! All of you!
They're hurting each other's feelings. I have to put a stop to this.
Oh, here we go. Spineless Pete worming his way back to the surface.
Do you want to know why I compromise, Nancy?
Yeah.
I'm modeling for these people. Yes, it's been 40 years, and yes, they're not exactly picking up what I'm laying down, but I believe in them. They have good in them. And eventually, they're gonna get there. And until that time, I'm gonna keep setting an example.
That's BS. You're just scared of someone not liking you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you wimp.
That is enough!
I'm powder off your wimp.
I cannot take one more minute of your bullying. You want me to stand up for myself and have a spine? Well, here we go! It is over between us. I am done listening to you. So if you have something you want to say to everyone, you just go ahead and say it.
Fine! I'm going back down to the basement. Because I just broke up with my very real boyfriend. And also, because you all suck. And I'd rather be with the cholera pit people. Proud of you, Petey.
Now you listen up good. I'm taking the moldy room, and I don't want to hear another word about it. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Does that mean she's single now? You see that blistering in the wood?
Termites.
Unfortunately.
Yep, termites love oak.
Actually, I think that's pine.
Pine? Are you some kind of idiot, Stuart? Look at the grain.
Is this something that needs to be taken care of right away?
Hey, how's my boy Pete doing, huh? Hello? Oh, okay, I get it. You're too good to talk to a cholera ghost. Well, la-di-da.
Hey, team.
Oh, man. I wish they'd stop walking over that.
Yeah, that pine's not looking good.
Oh, again with the pine. Are you trying to piss me off, Stuart?
Look, I'm not an expert.
No, the only thing you're an expert at is giving people cholera.
Welcome to Woodstone B&B.
Babe?
Oh my God.
It's all good. It's just an old house. It's not a curse. Enjoy your stay.
Oh, hey, Pete.
Oh, hey, Nancy.
Stop flirting. It's not happening. Jeez.
Okay, do people think I'm lying about the sex thing? Because I'm really not lying.
Don't worry. I know you tell truth. As ghost, I watch you many times.
Thank you. Wait, what?